Welcome to a series of videos designed to help you get the most out of Final Draft. In this tutorial, we're using a Mac, but we'll show you the Windows menus if they're different. Today, we'll focus on Autosave and Backup. Every time you save your script, and every time Final Draft auto-saves your script, a date and time-stamped backup is created and placed in the backup folder on your hard drive. The default number of backups stored is 100, but this quantity can be changed to a maximum of 1,000. When the limit is reached, the oldest backup will be purged when the newest backup is created. Setting your autosave preferences is crucial to protecting your work. Go to Final Draft, Preferences, Autosave, Backup, or Tools, Options, General on Windows. Set your autosave to whatever timing you prefer on Mac or Windows. You can set the number of copies to be saved up to 1,000. You can change the backup folder location to wherever you prefer, on the desktop, in a documents folder, in your Dropbox, Google Drive, or iCloud Sync folder, so that your backups will be saved both locally and in the cloud. Once you hit the copy save limit, Final Draft 11 will save over the oldest copy first. Each new copy saved is the most current copy of your script. If you like the draft you did yesterday better than the one you're working on today, simply go into your backups folder and retrieve it. Then rename that backup, removing the date and time, and saving it to a more convenient location. We hope you've enjoyed learning about autosave and backup, and that you're able to use both these tools in your writing process. If you have any comments or suggestions, we want to hear them. Just go to Help, Submit Feedback, and let us know what you think. If you need technical support, go to Help, Get Support for access to Final Draft resources, including email, chat, and phone services. To watch more helpful video tutorials, visit the Final Draft YouTube channel at youtube.com/FinalDraftInc. Final Draft, the industry standard screenwriting software.